It's cool HubSpot. You thought of that a while ago, didn't you?
2 years ago.
2 years ago. I'm excited to be here. I watch it all the time, and I really like knowing that Carrie is actually this big, folks, in real life. Mike and Carrie were in his pocket to get that article.
She is literally half my size. My chair is on the floor, and her slug can't beat me. So what is the murder mystery company? I'm hoping this is not like real life murder mystery. Like, that's what's scary.
No, it's not real life. Fake life.
Okay.
Murder mystery. So basically, we do come to you. We do a two-hour interactive murder mystery. Somebody dies in a comic way. It's time. Now, our new thing, and I'd like to show you guys this a little bit, is we actually bring out costumes and characters for everybody at the party. So, for instance, we might make Karen like Scarlet Maroon or something like that. Right, like that little character with your glasses here.
Ooh.
And then I do have a nice bubble for you. And we do have...
she actually wears that on a normal basis.
We do have Professor Mike right over there.
Just go this way. Is that the other
one?
I don't think it goes that way.
I think it goes that way. You're really not
hoping
to be the professor there.
No. My wife is a PhD. She's the professor in the family.
Fair enough. So, and basically, the murderer could be absolutely anybody. So, everybody has...
Or definitely Karen.
Or definitely Karen. Or likely probably Karen.
Who the murderer is.
Yes.
And so, these are entertainment events or corporate events or whatever?
Yeah, both. Okay. Both. So, we can be customers,
Cool.
I kind of figured you were too.
She's so fabulous.
So you started using HubSpot back in November 2009.
Yes.
What was the reason, like why I signed up with HubSpot? I mean, it seems like you guys are having a lot of fun all the time.
Yeah, well, when we started with HubSpot, we were kind of in Chicago doing a few shows, and we were in Michigan, we did that for a while, but your guys' blog. So we went to your guys' blog, I watched HubSpot TV some, and then eventually I'm like, you know what, I'm just going to go for it. And thank you, Brian Halligan, you gave me a lot of money. So I appreciate that.
Well, I think, because you emailed us before the show, because you were, by the way, you had one of the most excited emails about being on the show. It was like all capitals, like multiple lines, it was great. But I think you said that something like you grew, you used to say, grown, I think this is a direct quote from the email, grown from a theater company that could barely keep me employed to a company that has nearly 200 actors and a staff of 4 people that books calls and handles bookings.
Yes, absolutely. In basically like 1 year, I've gone from selling furniture to acting like an idiot in front of a lot of people. It's very exciting.
Also, you've done 43 blog articles, about 1 a week.
Yep, I've done 43 blog articles. Video blogs and stuff like that. Our big thing though is our website is growing massively. So our website's around 300 pages, and I think that's one of our biggest keys, because every single show that we do, we take pictures and we upload them. Everybody comes see that. We do the plan and murder thing on there, so we can rebook and stuff like that. And that's been massive. And then we just really long tail keyword search. You know, it'll be like murder mystery in Michigan, December 2010, and people search for that and get it.
I actually have a fabulous thing there. We talked about it before on the show, but it's figuring out how you can make content like everything you do. For example, we're here having a party with all our customers, and we're creating content.
Really? It also seems like you guys have had some success within social media too. It seemed like 650 fans or so on your Facebook page.
Yes. Yeah, we just signed up for it too.
Yeah.
So. We do a lot of Facebook. We do quite a bit of Twittering. Mainly Facebook, which is better prime focus. We start LinkedIn, and like Karen says, I don't really get it, but it's up to Facebook. So. Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Facebook, they go viral really easily. Yep. We get a lot of views from that. And if you're ever doing anything like that, I recommend photo bucket, putting that out there. We tried like 3 or 4 different ones, and Costco doesn't work. clickers doesn't work because you can't quite click and save the photos.
So then what's your favorite thing about that sign?
The fact that you guys have made me a lot of money. I mean, the customer service is fantastic. There's like three or four people that came here and hugged me, and I knew almost all of them, so that was exciting.
That is wonderful. You know,
one of them might have just been a weird homeless guy, I'm not sure. Does he work here?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
That's Alan Kennedy.
I gave him a dollar. I feel weird. Okay, I have two.
Oh, wow. Oh.
And props.
One is never letting a marketing opportunity pass by, so here are two shirts.
All right.
Don't worry, I will wear this all the time.
Fantastic.
There you go.
Okay.
And the other one is, in my opinion, just create as much content as you possibly can. You know, if you have any kind of customer service business whatsoever, take pictures, do stuff of them actually doing it, them enjoying it, letters that they've sent you. We do a lot of price breaks for people who write us stuff, and then we put that up. So we have all this, like, you know, and everything, positive feedback all over the web, everywhere, and that helps a lot. Most of our bread and butter, most of the leads and bookings that we get are always, they're never like murder mystery, but like murder mystery dinner, Southfield. You know, murder mystery dinner, small part of Boston.
It's a long town.
Yeah.
So fantastic. All right. Scott Cramton, everyone, from the Murder Mystery Company. Yes.
Oh, I'm staying at the end of the show. You all pretty much are clapped, and you should feel dumb.
Yeah. All right.
It's just, there's only two of us, so that's all.
Okay. Are you ready to read the marketing takeaway?
I think we are. Mike, what's the marketing takeaway?
So the marketing tip of the week. Says marketing takeaway here because we messed up the script, but that's okay. This is really just the beginning. We have over 50 case studies on the HubSpot website. We have 350 customers here for the event tonight and tomorrow, and we've had 5 customers here on the show. And what I'd encourage all of you to do throughout the entire world, through the internet and everyone who's here, is talk to the other customers and figure out what they're doing well that you're not doing yet. Because I think what's interesting about this collection of folks is a lot of people are having success with blogs, some people with landing pages, some people with other tools. Talk to everyone and figure out what they're doing that you're not doing that maybe you could start to try.
Yeah, I think that's true. You all hear, you know, great opportunities. You can learn so much and so much about